Welcome to an example of a composition of three functions. Given function f, g, and h, we want to determine f of g of h of x, which we can write using this notation here or this notation here. I prefer the notation on the right because it's easier to tell. We're going to start with the innermost function and work our way out. But remember, we can also think of this as f after g after h of x. In this composition, we don't have an input for function h, so we're going to go ahead and replace h of x with the square root of x. So this is going to be equal to f of g, and we're replacing h of x with the square root of x. Now that we performed the first substitution, notice how the inner function is g of the square root of x. So now we're going to go to function g and replace x with the square root of x. So this would give us f of, replacing x with the square root of x here, we would have 2 times the square root of x squared. And this simplifies to just 2x. So now we want to determine f of 2x, which means we're going to replace x with 2x in function f. So this would give us 2x to the third minus 2x, and then plus 1. So this will give us 2 to the third is 8, x to the third minus 2x plus 1. So this would be our composite function, f of g of h of x. So now let's take a look at a second example where we're given a value of x for the initial input. So here we have the same composite function, but we're given the initial value of x is equal to positive 4. So for this composition, we can actually find a numerical value for this composite function. And there's actually two ways of doing this. Since we already determined the composite function on the previous slide, or this function here, we can actually just substitute 4 for x into our composite function, which would give us 8 times 4 to the third minus 2 times 4 plus 1. Well, 4 to the third is equal to 64. 64 times 8 is 512 minus 8 plus 1. This is equal to 505. So f of g of h of 4 is equal to 505. Now, I would like to show a second method for determining this composite function value. For example, let's say we didn't have this composite function here. We probably wouldn't determine the composite function and then substitute 4 in for x. We would probably take a different approach, which I'll show now. We'll start with f of g of h of 4. And we'll start by determining the value of h of 4. Well, if we substitute 4 for x in function h, we would have the square root of 4, which is equal to 2. So we can replace h of 4 with 2, which would give us f of g of 2. Now we'd evaluate g of 2. Well, if we substitute 2 into function g, we'd have 2 times 2 squared, or 2 times 4, which is equal to 8. So this would simplify to f of 8. And then we'd replace x with 8 in function f, which would be 8 to the third minus 8 plus 1. Well, 8 to the third is 512 minus 8 plus 1. Notice how the value is the same, which it should be. F of g of h of 4 is equal to 505. So of course, whichever method we use, the value of the composite function when x equals 4 will be the same.